On tonight's Gwinnett Prep Rally, it's all good for the finals. Buford and Grayson play for all the marbles, and we've got the video as we root for the double dip. We'll even sprinkle in a little hoops concoction over the top of Will's World, who looks a lot like Brandon Brigman. Hey, whoever it is, we've got Gwinnett Prep Rally for you right now.
For more than 15 years, your source for Gwinnett County sports is Gwinnett Prep Rally.
Hello and welcome to your county's original high school sports television program. This is Gwinnett Prep Rally, now in its 19th season. We'll be with you on GCPS-TV right here for the entire 2011-2012 school year. I'm Todd Klein alongside Brandon Brigman from the Gwinnett Daily Post. And Brandon, the football state championship games are set, and we have two Gwinnett teams looking to bring home the big trophy.
Yeah, we got Gwinnett back in the Georgia Dome. Couldn't ask for a better way to end the season. Grayson playing Walton in a 5A state championship, and a rematch for the fourth year, Buford versus Calhoun in the AA state championship.
Well, we will have game highlights from both Buford and Grayson's semifinal victories later in the show. But first up, we go to the hard courts for a little hoops action as the Parkview Lady Panthers look to continue their hot start to the season in a non-region matchup with visiting Centennial. GPR's Nathan Shutter has more.
The Parkview Lady Panthers looking to keep their hot start going against visiting Centennial. First quarter, Panthers on the break. Ashley Logan finds Erica Joseph underneath. She'll pump fake a couple of times and lay it in for two. Then she'll show off the defensive awareness, coming up with the steal and banking in the shot to give Parkview a 6-0 lead. Centennial will have an answer, but the loose ball bounces to Paige Elliott. She puts it in for two, and we are all knotted at six after one quarter of action. Second quarter, Parkview with some good ball movement, working it down low to Vicky Harris, and the freshman shows off some nice low post moves. Parkview back up by two. Genesis Perryman steps into the passing lane for the steal, and she heads the other way, all the way for the easy deuce. Parkview leads 20-14 at the break. Second half, and Centennial will come out strong with a 7-0 run. Chelsea Reese makes the steal, and she'll take it all the way to the rack for two. That will cut the Parkview lead to just 1 point. Then it's Becca Davis firing a pass ahead to Lauren Spence. She'll stop and pop the baseline jumper to give Centennial a 21-20 advantage. Harriman with a long pass ahead to Harris. She gets the bucket and draws contact. Parkview up 35-25 after three. And they will continue to roll in the fourth. Harriman with a bounce pass to Ashley Logan on the block. She puts it up and gets the friendly roll to extend the Parkview lead to 14. Then, off the Centennial turnover, Perryman with a one-handed pass to a wide-open Logan for the easy bucket. And Parkview pulls away from Centennial for a 48-26 win over the Knights.
Parkview looking good to start the season, Brandon. A lot of that has to do with their defense. Defense was just all over Centennial.
Yeah, they graduated one of their top offensive threats in Katie Carroll, but it looks like they're not really going to miss her when you're playing defense like that. They ended up holding Centennial to 1 point in the fourth quarter. And you do that, playing good defense, you're going to win a lot of ball games.
And we think Parkview's probably going to play good defense all year. That looks like their MO, but they also have a good offensive coach in Tony Watkins. He's new to Parkview, not new to Gwinnett County, and not new to success. How do you think Tony Watkins will turn out over at Parkview?
Yeah, Tony's been around for quite some time. He's had some successful stints everywhere he's gone, Shiloh, North Gwinnett, and I see him continuing that here at Parkview. Parkview has a lot of good players coming back. They'll definitely be a playoff caliber team, and with Tony, he can get him a deep playoff run, hopefully.
More highlights now as we head back to Parkview for the nightcap, featuring the boys matchup as the Panthers look to hand Centennial their third straight loss to start the season. Nathan Shutter has all the action from Lilburn.
Parkview playing host to Centennial in an early season non-region tilt. The Panthers will get the scoring started. Darius Marshall drives and kicks to TJ Thomas at the top of the key, and he deposits two off the glass to give the home team the lead. It would be short-lived as Charles Pack will kick it to a wide-open Michael Pack in the corner, and he buries the triple to put Centennial up by four. More from the Knights. Charles Pack with a long pass ahead to Finetto Linguano, and he throws down the two-handed jam. Centennial up 16-11 after one. Second quarter, Jalen Abraham ahead to Andre Chatfield, and he throws it down with authority to cut the lead to one. Centennial will respond. Linguano drives towards the hoop and dumps it off to Christian Lynch for the easy lay-in to put the Knights up 23-17. Then it's Linguano showing off his range and knocking down the three. Centennial goes to the break up 30-21. Second half and the Knights begin to pull away. Charles Pack's shot hits off the front of the iron, but Parker Stevenson is there for the board and the stick back. Then it's Carlos Hamlet and Michael Pack with a little back and forth. Hamlet pulls the trigger and swishes the tray. Knights in control up by 17. Panthers looking for a spark. Andre Chatfield comes up with a steal, and he's going the other way, all the way for the high percentage bucket. Parkview down by 11 after three. But Centennial would close them out in the fourth. Eric Lynch with a no-look pass to Linguana for the easy layup, and Centennial pulls away from Parkview by a final of 69-56.
Well, Brandon, this was a tough one for Parkview. A good early season matchup for the Panthers, though a young team, they need to be tested like this to get ready for region. Where do you see that the Panthers have to make their biggest improvement if they want to make a little run in Region A5A?
Yeah, I mean, it's still early in the season. They lost to a really good playoff caliber team in Centennial, so you know you don't want to put too much onto this on this loss, but you know they got to find some offensive scoring threats. You do that, and you're going to have a better shot there towards the end of the year.
And obviously, Region A5A is good in every sport. How do you see Parkview fitting in here? Right now, would you guess that they're a playoff team, or are they a team that really is probably going to have to work to get one of those four spots?
Yeah, right now I would say they're probably on the outside looking in. Region 8 is really good this year when you got your South Gwinnett, your Berkmar, your Shiloh. I think they're sort of right there on the fringe. They do have a chance to maybe sneak into that four spot, but you know they obviously have a lot of work to do.
Time now to recap other hoops action from around the county. It's brought to you by Breda Pest Management. Start things off with the Berkmar Patriots, who you just mentioned, Brandon.
Yeah, Berkmar got off to a nice win, beating Brookwood 66-48. Adonai Rogers led the charge with 17 points, while Tim Rowe had 15 points and 7 rebounds.
And obviously, Berkmar off to a good start, and you said that they will be a factor in the Region A5A race. And we see with their athleticism, one of the reasons that they will be. Move over to Mill Creek, another tough region, Region 7-5A. Tough to play in that region, but Mill Creek starting off in a way that you go, hey, they're going to be around at the end of the year.
Yeah, they get a nice 56-42 win over Wesleyan. Wesleyan's obviously in Class A, but they're always one of the top teams in the state in the smaller divisions. They got 19 points from Paul Evans in the winning effort.
And then we move over to the Brookwood girls on the girls' side, Region 8-5A. Brookwood girls get a nice win over Berkmar.
Yeah, Brookwood obviously had a great year last year, going undefeated for most of the season. They got a 55-50 win over Berkmar. Courtney Gardner led the team with 19 points. Rebecca Walker had 18 points and 10 blocks. So that's a great way to get off to region play.
And obviously we know how good basketball is in Gwinnett County and those two regions that we mentioned, Brandon. Going back to Berkmar, we know Region A5A is going to be a dogfight. How do you think Berkmar works in there, and is Berkmar a region title type of team?
Yeah, I mean, I think they'll be in there for the region title, obviously. You know, that region tournament's a big factor. You just want to get in there, get a good matchup, and go from there. I think they'll be in there, but also I like Shiloh and I like South Gwinnett, and they're fighting for it as well.
All right, when we come back, we'll have more football highlights from the state semifinals as Grayson looked to avenge last year's loss to Colquitt County, while Buford faced a very familiar foe on the road. And we get into the mind of our very own Brandon Brigman. You're watching Gwinnett Prep Rally on GCPS-TV. For 19 years, the county's high school sports television program.
For two decades, Calder Sports has been making dreams possible for thousands of Gwinnett County student athletes.
Sometimes we've been over the top.
Thrill is gone.
Steve Calder sings.
And the leader of the clan will take no prisoners on this day.
Sometimes we've been straight to the point.
Beverly Calder is the most persuasive sporting goods salesman in Gwinnett County history, and that's including her son, Steve.
But most of all, we've cared deeply about every Gwinnett parent and student who walked through this front door.
Over all these years,
we thank you for your support.